Hello everyone and welcome! In this video we recreate in Unity 3D the character customization menu of Animal Crossing New Horizons. Since the project is composed by several steps, we'll show and explain the main phases. If you want to explore more, remember that you can download the full project, complete of all the assets, from GitHub. Let's begin! First thing we need is a rigged character. Instead of a human, we create and customize Tom Nook. He is a raccoon and rumors say that he is the evil of the story. In a new Blender project, we start importing reference images and for first we model a sphere to obtain the raccoon's head. Proportional editing here is very important. It allows you to move big portion of vertex together in a natural way. The work here is to try to match the reference shape while keeping a good topology. Topology is how the vertices and edges are placed to create the surface. Mastering it takes time, and each model you create makes you better. A good topology makes in-game models optimized, allow UV seams, improve mesh deformations, and minimize changes between vertex normal for better shading. After the head, we proceed to model arms, the body, legs, and the tail. Once the model is ready, we create the armature. An armature can be thought as a real skeleton and in fact, it is composed by bones. These bones are attached to the mesh and by moving them you obtain a mesh deformation. This is part of the rigging process. To create a connection between a bone and the mesh, you need to associate weights. Weights are applied by painting them with brushes. In general, you select a bone and color with red the area you want to move with it and blue the area not affected by the bone. After this, you can test in the pose mode if the model is moving as you expect by moving bones. Last operation is to unwrap the model and create a UV map. Unwrapping means to unfold a mesh into 2D texture. You define edge that the unwrap process will cut and project onto a texture. You can then paint on this mesh coordinates with programs like Photoshop, GIMP and so on. Once you import back the colored image and apply it to the material of the model, you obtain a textured model. In a new Unity project, we import the raccoon and the texture. For now, we create and assign unlit materials. At the end, we will polish, add light and lit materials. Then, we create an idle animation trying to replicate the original one in Animal Crossing. With 3D elements we are done. Now we need all the 2D assets. We start from recreating the background in Photoshop. Then, we recreate all the icons of the UI thanks to Illustrator. Inside the project, in addition to the single PNG icons, you will find the Illustrator file so that you can customize everything as you prefer. To render the character onto the UI canvas, we use two cameras. The player camera renders only the player layer, where Tom Nook is, and write the result in a render texture. The render texture is then used as a texture of a raw image. In this way, if the camera renders everything except the player layer, we can see Tom onto the canvas. To position all the icons in the UI, we add as background a screenshot of Animal Crossing so that we can find the position in a simple way. Last assets we need are the player's accessory. Back in Blender, we create two kinds of hairs, a mouth and eyes. Also, we create two new textures for the skin tone menu. We position all the accessories under the bone of the head and we make sure that they move correctly while rotating the bone. To change eyes, we don't swap different eyes models, but we change the offset of the eyes material texture. Now that we have all the 3D and 2D assets, let's talk about the mechanics of the menu. First of all, we have the navigation system. To move across buttons, we use a PS4 DualShock controller. the new Unity input system comes to help. All we need to do is install the package, accept to replace the old standard input system, create a new asset called input action where you have to add all the inputs you will use, add the component called player input and listen for the action in your scripts. By using gamepad inputs, our menu will work with any types of gamepad. The menu is composed by sections. A section includes a top bar icon with different states and all the buttons of the page. Buttons can also be divided into different groups, but one thing at a time. All starts from a top bar manager. Here we have a list of objects of type section, skin tone, hairstyle, eyes, nose and mouth, and by pressing the left or right shoulder of the gamepad, we can move between them. When we activate a section, we use a section's method called endostate. This swaps the sprite of the top bar and initializes the buttons. While the top bar navigation is guided by our custom script, the movement across the buttons is handled automatically by the event system. In fact, by setting the event system to use the new input system, we can navigate without any further implementation. Also, very helpful in this situation, where you need to activate the activate states when you pass over buttons, are buttons interfaces. For example, if you want to detect when a button is selected or deselected, you can easily inherit from the right button interface and in the event method make your custom operations. Here we swap sprites and graphic contents. Now the character customization. All we need is to group buttons by categories and assign to each of them a unique ID per category. In this way, when we click them, we can identify which button has been clicked by its ID and category. A group of buttons can only have one element active and equipped. This is why certain sections have two groups of buttons. The hair section has a group of buttons to handle the hair type and one to handle the color, each with its own state. Clicking on a button sends to the equipment manager his ID and category. In this class, with a switch case, we understand what we have to do. We have different operations. One to switch the texture of the body material. One to switch between hair meshes. One to set the hair color thanks to the setColor method of the hair's material. One to set the offset property of the eye's texture. And two, similar to the hair one, but to change the nose and the mouth. Don't change the eyes color and the cheeks because the mechanic is similar to what we had just seen in the other sections. Try to do your custom version of them. Remember that if you want to color eyes, you need to separate the inner part of the eyes in a different mesh and assign to its material an empty or black and white texture. Last important mechanics we need to cover are camera movement and player rotation. When switching between sections, camera moves to render the player from different view angles. This is easily achieved thanks to spawn points and linear interpolation. To rotate the player around this vertical axis, we add a new action to the input and we create a new script called rotate character. Important here is to notice how we read the input. In fact, each update frame, we read the input value directly from the action rotate player. If you want to read directly inputs, remember to enable or disable the input master. After some polishing operations, like adding lights, make the confirm pop up, and adding a look at animation to Tom, this is the final result. What do you think about it? If you enjoyed this video, click the thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. This is very important and it will help us to reach more people. For any question, write a comment in the section below. See you next time. Bye!